4 billion years ago, something happened at the edge of our solar system that we're only discovering right now. Scientists just found an ancient world that's been circling out there since Earth was a ball of molten rock, and its very existence is forcing us to rethink whether Planet 9 is real or just a phantom we've been chasing. The paper dropped in Nature Astronomy 2 weeks ago. A team using the Subaru telescope in Hawaii spotted something they're calling Ammonite, officially 2023 KQ14. And before you zone out thinking this is just another space rock, understand this. We've only found four objects like this in all of human history. Four. In the entire solar system. And this fourth one? It's pointing the wrong way. Let me back up. Remember that whole Planet 9 thing? The idea that there's a hidden world 5 to 10 times Earth's mass lurking in the darkness, shepherding distant icy objects into weird clustered orbits? For almost a decade, that clustering was the smoking gun. Three ultra-distant objects called Sednoids, Sedna, Biden, and Leilacuhonua, all seemed to loop around the sun in the same general direction, like cosmic sheep being herded by an invisible shepherd. The math said something massive had to be out there organizing them. Ammonite just wandered in from the opposite direction. This isn't some minor discrepancy. Imagine you're convinced there's a sheepdog because all the sheep are bunched together on one side of the field. Then you spot a sheep on the completely opposite side, doing its own thing, totally ignoring where it's supposedly being herded. That's Ammonite. Its orbit swings out 252 astronomical units from the sun. That's 252 times the Earth-Sun distance, but it does it in the opposite direction from where the others cluster. The discovery itself is almost as interesting as what it means. Nobody saw this coming because Ammonite was hiding in a gap everyone thought was empty. For years, astronomers noticed something strange. Plenty of objects orbit between 30 and 50 AU from the sun, and we knew about these extreme Sednoids beyond 75 AU, but nothing in between. That 50 to 75 AU zone? Ghost town. Some thought it was just hard to spot objects there. Others wondered if something had cleared them out. Turns out Ammonite has been sailing through that gap for 4.5 billion years. It comes within 66 AU of the sun, right in that mysteriously empty zone, then swings out into the void on a 4,000-year journey. One complete orbit takes as long as the entire span from the Bronze Age to today. The last time Ammonite was where it is now, humans hadn't invented writing yet. What really has astronomers scrambling is what happened when they ran the simulations. See, if you rewind Ammonite's orbit 4.2 billion years, back when the solar system was young and chaotic, something fascinating emerges. Back then, Ammonite actually was clustered with the other Sednoids. They were all pointing the same direction, all grouped together, like something really had organized them. Then something changed. The models suggest all four Sednoids started out clustered, but while three stayed somewhat aligned, Ammonite got knocked onto a completely different path. And here's the thing. Once it got bumped into its current orbit, it stayed there, perfectly stable, for billions of years. Whatever happened, happened once, early on, and then nothing touched it again. The team spent months verifying this wasn't a fluke. They found old images going back to 2005 where Ammonite had been photographed but never noticed. 19 years of positions, all confirming the same weird orbit. This thing is only about 300 kilometers across, roughly the distance from New York to Boston, a tiny frozen world that takes 11 hours for its reflected sunlight to reach Earth. Not 11 minutes, 11 hours. So what pushed Ammonite away from its siblings? The paper lays out the suspects. Maybe a star passed close to the sun when it was young, gravitationally yanking some objects one way and others another way. Maybe there really was a planet out there. Call it Planet 9, Planet X, whatever. But it got ejected from the solar system after scrambling these orbits. Or maybe Planet 9 is still out there, but much farther away than anyone thought. That last possibility is what has Planet 9 believers clinging to hope. The paper doesn't say Planet 9 is dead. What it says is if Planet 9 exists, it can't be where we thought it was. The original predictions put it a few hundred AU out. But those predictions would have Planet 9's gravity either capturing Ammonite into alignment or ejecting it entirely. The fact that Ammonite is just there doing its own thing means any hidden planet would need to be at least 500 AU away. Maybe more. 500 AU. That's 5 times farther than the distance to the theoretical planet 9 was supposed to be. Light from the sun would take almost 3 days to reach it. Any world that far out would be nearly impossible to spot with current technology. We're not talking about finding a needle in a haystack anymore. We're talking about finding a specific snowflake in Antarctica. But let's be real about what this discovery actually tells us. The authors are careful. They talk about constraints and parameter space and transition walls. What they're dancing around is that Ammonite doesn't fit the story. You can make the math work if you really want to. Push Planet 9 farther out, make it more eccentric, change its mass, add some special conditions. But at some point, you're just adding epicycles to save a theory. The lead scientist, Ying-Tung Chen, put it diplomatically, Ammonite lowers the likelihood of the Planet 9 hypothesis. That's scientists speak for, this doesn't look good. Another team member, Yukin Huang, was more direct. If Planet 9 was where we thought it was, Ammonite shouldn't exist in its current orbit. Here's what bugs me about all this, and what the papers don't really address. We now have 4 Sednoids. 4. That's our entire sample size for these extreme objects. 3 seemed to cluster, so we invented a massive planet to explain it. Now the 4th doesn't cluster, and we're scrambling to adjust the theory. What happens when we find the 5th one? The 10th? The 20th? The Vera Rubin Observatory just came online in Chile. Over the next few years, it's going to discover hundreds, maybe thousands of new distant objects. Every one of them is a test of the Planet 9 hypothesis. And if Ammonite is any indication, that hypothesis is about to face a lot of tests it might not pass. There's an even deeper issue nobody's talking about. These Sednoids are fossils from the solar system's birth. Their orbits unchanged for billions of years. They're telling us something profound happened in those first few hundred million years. But we keep trying to explain them with things that exist now. A planet that's still out there, still shepherding. What if that's backwards? What if the real story is about something that happened once, violently, and then ended? The paper hints at this. Those simulations showing all 4 Sednoids clustered 4 billion years ago, that suggests they were organized by something back then, not now. Maybe a planet that got ejected. Maybe a star that passed by and left. Maybe the sun formed in a dense stellar cluster where gravitational chaos was the norm. The point is, we might be looking for a ghost. Think about the situation we're in. We have 4 lonely worlds on bizarre orbits at the edge of the solar system. Each one takes thousands of years to complete a single orbit. They're so far away it takes half a day for their light to reach us. And from these 4 objects, 4, we're trying to deduce the existence of a massive hidden planet. That's like finding 4 random footprints in the Sahara and concluding there must be an invisible elephant based on their pattern. Then when you find a 5th footprint pointing the wrong way, instead of questioning the elephant, you decide it must be a really distant elephant. At some point, maybe there just isn't an elephant. The timing of this is almost poetic. Just last month, remember, there was that potential Planet 9 detection in old infrared data that turned out to be nothing. Now Ammonite shows up, refusing to play along with the clustering theory. It's like the universe is trying to tell us something. What strikes me is how this mirrors my April video about that other discovery. 2017 of 201. That object also refused to follow the Planet 9 clustering pattern. Now Ammonite makes 2 major outliers in just a few months. The pattern isn't holding, but here's what's genuinely exciting, beyond all the Planet 9 drama. Ammonite proves the outer solar system is still full of surprises. This thing was photographed in 2005 and nobody noticed. It was in publicly available data for almost 20 years. How many more Ammonites are out there, hidden in plain sight, waiting to overturn our theories? The fossil survey that found Ammonite, that name isn't random, by the way. They're literally looking for fossils of the early solar system. They're going to keep searching. Every new discovery is another piece of the puzzle. Maybe that puzzle shows a 9th planet. Maybe it shows something weirder. Maybe it shows nothing at all, just chaos and chance at the edge of the sun's influence. And about those corrections to consider, the claim about ammonite being stable for 4.5 billion years is based on models, not direct observation. Obviously, we can't actually prove something has been stable for longer than we've been watching it. Ammonite is real. Its orbit is wrong for Planet 9. And every attempt to save the hypothesis requires pushing the hypothetical planet farther away, making it harder to detect, less able to explain what we see. You know what this reminds me of? The old astronomy story about Vulcan, not the Star Trek planet, the one astronomers thought existed inside Mercury's orbit to explain Mercury's weird motion. They spent decades looking for it. Reported sightings, drew up orbital predictions. Then Einstein came along with general relativity and explained Mercury's orbit without needing a hidden planet at all. Vulcan never existed. It was just a ghost born from incomplete physics. Maybe Planet 9 is our generation's Vulcan, a beautiful theory killed by an ugly fact. Or maybe, it's out there at 500 AU, barely gravitationally bound to the Sun, so far away that finding it will take decades. Either way, ammonite just made the hunt a lot more interesting. The universe doesn't care about our neat theories. It's messier than we want it to be, fuller of surprises. And sometimes the most profound discovery isn't finding what you're looking for. It's finding something that proves you were looking for the wrong thing all along.